Hi, I'm Jonas Torning. I'm working as a hardware procurement manager for our compute platforms here at Glesys, which basically means I get to spend somebody else's money on buying fancy hardware. Please join me here where we unbox some of Supermicro's latest X14 compute platforms in our data center. Let's go inside and have a look. This is a Supermicro X14. It's a brand new model that's just been released, and we're really excited to get our hands on it. As you can see, it has an OCP slot, which is becoming industry standard, and two regular PCIe slots, and a modular slot for your IPMI. So it's actually on a removable board by itself. It follows the DC modular hardware system that is a standard set by Open Compute. This is also the first server that we buy where we don't have a VGA port for console output. It's actually been replaced with a mini display port and a USB-C interface. So we're going to have to update our crash cart or console wagons to support the new standard. Let's open it up. You'll see that the inside also follows the modular hardware system that I was talking about earlier. That's not just not the IPMI, it's also for the connector to the power supply. And you can see how the backplane is connected to the motherboard. It's shrunk, so it's very small compared to previous generations. One of the benefits with the Xeon 6 platform is the increased core count per socket, meaning we don't have to run dual socket systems. This is an 86 core CPU from the 6700 series. It's all P cores. There are other models available with mixes P cores and E cores for efficiency or if it matches your workload. This one is for as much performance per dollar as possible. As I mentioned earlier, this system uses the DC-MHS, the modular hardware system. And one of the things that's fundamentally changed from previous generation of servers is that the ATX connectors is no more. You have these connectors that resembles the PCIe connectors you have to your graphics card, for example. And this is one of the reasons you can make the motherboard so much smaller, because the footprint of these connectors is less than half of the old ATX standard. For reference, this is what a dual socket system board looked like a few generations back, where you can see the ATX 12 volt connectors, for example, and how big this thing actually is compared to that. This one will almost not fit inside the chassis. So huge improvement. The backplane is hybrid, meaning it will accept your SATA, SAS, NVMe U2, NVMe U3 using the same backplane. And the same cabling will support SATA and NVMe, optional controller required for SAS, of course. One of the things with the increased core count is, of course, the increased TDP, or the how hot the system runs. And as you can see, the fans are heavy duty, and there's 8 of them instead of 6 as there was in previous generations. So you can actually handle up to 350 watts TDP in air cooled in 1U. We also like the modularity of this motherboard, so we can use the same motherboard for 2U systems later on. So it will actually have not just the risers as we see here, but you actually have additional PCIe ports that you can connect to your riser cards. So we can keep these spare parts to a minimum. While on the subject of increased RAM bandwidth, you should probably also mention that this server supports the multiplexed rank DIMMs, allowing for a much higher memory density plus the increased bandwidth. So basically, what we're going to do now is install this server and see that it plays nicely with our management platforms, and see that we can find a VGA to USB-C adapter so it will work with our console stations. If there's anything else you would like us to unbox or do a video around, just let us know in the comments, and thank you so much for watching.